Now we can jump into the external interfaces. Yes, so we had many internal interfaces, like some of them were universal, like SPI, I2C, UART, and image transfer interfaces, very fast interfaces like LVDS, RGB, that was parallel one, MIPI Vx1, and EDP, embedded display port. And here we have external ones, the ones that we usually have access to. So for example, it can be HDMI. Yes, so with HDMI we can connect our computer with the monitor or TV. Then DVI, usually used for monitors only, VGA, that is an old image interface for monitors, and DisplayPort. It's like a new HDMI, let's say. And universal interfaces I put here on the USB or USB-C, because it's the most common and universal interface nowadays to connect devices to each other. So let's start with the universal one, that will be USB, and particular USB-C, because I think it's one of the best interfaces that we ever designed, because this interface, finally, I would say USB Alliance did it, is a really fast one and very universal. That means it can not only transfer the data, but because it's fast, it can also transfer the image, because it's fast enough, and it also can transfer a lot of power, actually up to 100 watts of power, because we can increase the voltage. Like regular USB, you know, maybe it's usually like 5 volt power and maybe half amp power or like 1 amp, so few watts only. And for USB-C, we can go with the voltage as high as 20 volt with the 5 amp in total, so we can have even 100 watt of power. That means this interface is not only for data, but a real power transfer. So we can not only maybe charge our phone, but we can charge our laptop through USB-C. So if you will buy the new laptop right now, maybe you will not have the regular power connector, but it could be USB-C only. And the USB-C is a very smart interface. So if you connect two devices, they can negotiate with each other which one has more power. So if, for example, we connect the charger to the laptop, the charger of course has more power and will charge the laptop. But if we connect laptop with the same interface to our mobile phone, then they will discuss with each other, and of course the laptop will be charging the phone through the same interface. So it's a really smart interface to be used, and as I mentioned, it's very fast. So from our point of view, the fast is important, because we can build displays with a USB-C. And actually, you can find already on the market, they are very popular, monitors that will not have HDMI anymore, but will have only USB-C. And this kind of monitor you can even power, yes, from your computer. So some of the monitors, maybe not the large ones, they may have only one cable. So only like both for image transfer and for power from USB. So the future, for sure, we will see more and more USB-C use cases, and this interface is really fantastic in my opinion. Okay, and then we will jump from universal USB interface into the image transfer interface. First one, the most common on the market, of course, is HDMI, so high definition multimedia interface, multimedia, because it transfers not only the image, but also the sound, of course. So if you will connect your computer to your TV, you will have just one cable for both, yes, for video and for sound, and this is HDMI. And we have few variation of the connectors. We have standard HDMI, then we have a mini HDMI and micro HDMI, so a little bit different connectors, but the pinout and everything else is the same, yes? So popular and easy to use interface. Then the next one we have